Hi everyone, Shirley Peters here. Thanks for joining me. Today we're going to be doing a town in Austria called Hallstatt, or Hallstatt, not quite sure of the pronunciation, but it's a beautiful little village on the side of a lake. There's a salt mine. It is quite popular with tourists, but it's also a very classic view. Little church, buildings on the side facing the sun. My husband and I were there more than 10 years ago. We did this, we took lots of photographs. This is our photo. So you're welcome to download it for free from my website to help you do the painting. And also I'll do the sketch and I'll have that available for download as well. So it's a fairly complicated sketch. I do think it's time consuming. I'll fast forward it for the video's sake. If you want to see any of my sketching videos full slow, let me know in the comments below, and I might put it up as a small extra video with just a private link. So I'll get started. I'm using watercolour. I'm using Archer's paper. I've got my good and my cheap brushes combination. And what else? That's it. But what I did want to say was, if you could like and subscribe, and hit the notification bell, that way you're notified every time I upload a new video, which is about once a week, once every 10 days. And also, please stay well. And if you've got the bug, I'm sorry for you. Please get better soon. It's not very pleasant, that's for sure. So I'll turn the camera now and we'll get started on the sketch. Okay, first things, please excuse my fingers. I'm not able to get to nail polish people, so I'm doing it myself. I've been helping Bob with painting this morning and I've got paint on my fingers as well. Now I'm going to start with a 3B here. I think I'd rather have a 4B if I can find my 4B. Actually, here's a 4B. When they get small like that, I like to put them, grab a little holder. Put the pencil in the holder, it makes such a difference. So what I've done is folded this into quarters and I shall lay it down the middle of the page just so that I get a more accurate measure of what's at the centre of my page. So I'm looking roughly there to there and there to there. And then I'll put my finger there and I'll just pop a little dot in the middle. And that gives me an idea of my first line, albeit crooked. And I'll put my picture on the side, but I need to keep it loose so I can keep grabbing it. And I'm going to give this pencil a little bit of a sharp. That's not sharp enough for me. Just going to mix up a decent batch of blue and add a tiny bit of purple to it. Because of the distance, I want it to be a cool blue over there. Just going to add that in now. I've got plenty of water on this brush, this mop. Oh, by the way, brushes are listed below, and the paints. I'm just going to put the blue down the back here as a distant mountain. I think I can go right across the... Mount Steeple. The areas that I have to be careful of are areas that I want to be white. So that's the little area underneath those panels of tiles. It's got some little roofs, but I don't know what that is. I'll go right down into where the trees are. I'm even going to go towards tops of the buildings. I'm just trying to think which ones I might leave white. I might leave that one white. And that one white. And the part of that. Other than that, you know, you can just mop over. Not leaving anything white down here. Going right in. Okay, I'll mix up a little bit of brown, a little bit of burnt sienna, sepia. I've got a nice sepia there, burnt umber, put that on those buildings. Okay, rooftop there. Letting this happen because what I want to do is blend it in so that it's got a nice soft distant edge. Okay. I'll leave a little bit of white, I'll smooth it in a little bit, but I'll leave a little bit of white around the edge just for the possibility of cars that might be white there. So I'm bringing the paint down into this area up here. Okay, I'll let that go for a little while. I'll come back to this beautiful water here now. So I'm going to mix up a large batch of blue with the manganese blue hue. Make it lovely greeny but strong. Oh, this thing here is lovely, cobalt teal. Oh, I love it. So I'll get some of that going. Yep, it's quite, actually quite a little bit too, if you can see that, I don't know. It's a little bit too opaque. I didn't realise how opaque it was. Okay, go back to get more ultramarine into that. Bring it back to blue, like as in ready blue. Pop this in. Leave a couple of white parts there that I can work with later. Bring that around. Right. So it's a blue base. I'll come back to something else later. Swing that around. I know that there's beautiful wash there. It's not as obvious in the photograph as it looked in real life, but I remember it being really fantastic. So I'll just bring that right round. Right. A little shade under there. A couple of lines over here. Going to wet the brush. Look,
Actually, I'll wash the brush. I hate to lose all that blue. I should have wiped it back in there. Still. I'm just going to wet these areas here that I've left white. That building there, I'm going to try, it doesn't have a big reflection underneath, but I'm going to put one in, which means kind of pulling out that area. And while I'm here, something else, I might do that front one there. So because it's the water, you can always come back a little bit later on. And in fact, while I'm here, it's while it's wet, I will add some dark brown. Right in there. And that'll mix with the blue. Do as it's told. Just to behave itself. And just mix in with the blue and cause beautiful reflections from those buildings. There's a myriad of different colours. Well, they're subtle shades, I should say. They're not bright colours, but just at this stage. Fudging in what looks like it might be useful. Now, I guess I really want to put that wash in there. Kind of at a stage where you put it in when it's half, the background colour's half wet. You want soft edges on it, but on the other hand, I'm just going to do some crazy hat in there. Underneath here, I'll add some brown too, but there's not a lot in the photograph that I can see. It's more at the back here. Underneath in there. Shape of this is kind of reflected down here, so I'll pull down some shapes into that area. So basically working with brown and blue, they're the two colours, they're just fantastic. Lovely big sort of figure of eight patterns in this wash. I guess it depends on what type of engine it was running at the time, to what type of, how patterned the water becomes. Okay. Now I'm beginning to think this white is unnecessary. So I'm going to, well, I might just do a bit of the, just for the sake of reflecting the sky, a bit of the pale blue there. One thing wrong with this pad of paper is, as it gets smaller, it sits below the ledge, and you can't get to the bottom. So I'm going to have to go through and just fudge that through. And hopefully, because it's still wet, that should still fill in. Just going to now go back up here and add the subtlest of subtle background shades, just grey, and see if I can pick out a little bit of the, oops, not that strong of course. Because it's now pretty dry up there, it's not going to disappear all that easily, so I'm just going to fudge in with the, keep adding water so that it's finer, with the thin wash to try and give a feeling of the mountain. It's It's out of focus. I shouldn't be able to see lines or details. But I'll just try and put them in, and I might, when they're half dry, I might come back over them with a little bit of water and just see if I can loosen the edges. So I'm just taking that across the top of those buildings. Funnily enough, there is some sort of very faint warmth in those. Let's just see if I can add that in without getting too dark. That's the trouble. Oh, I think one of the secrets of this will be to punch out this area so strong that this background becomes less important. I'll just wet my brush. I'm leaving it to dry just for a touch while I get ready. I'll soak up these little beads. You don't want those. So what I might do... Actually, I might just give it a spray. I don't normally do this. Not in my style, but just give it a bit of a spray and see if I can soften that up. Oh, that's better. And I'll use a handy fan brush. Distant detail. Put such a fine line through. Just a couple of little, if I can pull out some more white from this water, I will. Pretty important you do this when it's still wet, because it's easier. You can do it when it's dry, but it's much easier when it's wet. Just one of those little... it's back here. Okay. Three little lines down. If you can't pull it out now, and I'm having trouble getting these out, you can come over it with white paint later. Give you permission to do that. A little bit more obedient, this brush. It's a flat. Water on it. Pick out some light that's catching on those waves as they pass. Because they're all waves, so they've all got shape to them. Pick that up. Do a couple more in here. This is where the quality watercolour paper allows you to do this type of thing. This is what makes a difference. If you're wondering if I can use the Canson paper, you could, but what happens, and it's happening a little bit here, the paper itself starts to tear because it's wet. And it starts to put little bubbles of rolled up paper on the surface. Now, over here, there's some horizontals needed. Because this is quite calm, it hasn't been ruffled yet. So I'll pop in a few peaceful horizontal lines. So that's a secret to water too. Something's vertical and then go over it sideways. Have a play around in your own time. It's good fun. Down here I can see there's some beautiful patterns I could play with there, but I probably won't do that on this video. Let's see what I can do here. Okay. Good. Getting there. Challenge at this stage is to mix a fairly pale, distant brown that will have blue in it, because it's going to be, oh, that's purple, okay. Neutral grey, basically. And I'll start on a couple of the little trees over here. Some horizontal lines to get them to. Still, and what I'll do is have, in the palette, I'll have slightly, I'll have a warmer neutral in there, which if I paint on the back of something, hang on. Grab a spare piece of paper. What I like to do is have a cooler neutral, like a dull blue, maybe not that blue. Okay, so how about that? Okay, cool and neutral, and then I shall also have a warmer neutral. Okay, that'll do. So what I'll be doing is going from one to the other. And every now and then, popping out and getting another colour if I think I need one. But I rather like the idea of these cool rooftops that I'm doing here. That one's a bit brown. Fading into, because it's wet behind, it's just melting back into the distance. Dark heaviness on the brush, and then wet the brush and squish it around like lovely gradation. In this case, this building here has got a little bit of shadow in the bottom half, but on the whole it's a little bit cooler on this side because the sun's on the other side. So I'll stick to that. And then the bricks themselves seem to go through a lighter stage down the bottom, but I'll ignore that altogether. If you're looking closely at the photograph, you'll see what I mean there. I won't do the chimney. I won't do the steeple until a little bit later into the work. Same with that tree growing up there. I won't do that one as of yet, because I would much rather have it dry. And do the tree in front, some other little areas of tone. Not sure that I'm happy with this brush. It's beginning to become a little bit. See, there's what's happening are the little lumps are beginning to separate. The hairs are separating. That's a sign of, to me, a dying brush. You have to move on. So next stage, it's a bigger brush. I didn't really want to go this big, and you know what, it's cheap, it must be cheap because there's no label on it whatsoever. It says size 20, so it would have been just one of those nylon brushes that you can get from just an art, generic art supply shop. There's a tiny bit of colour back there. I'm tempted to put it in, but then I'm tempted not to. Do I, don't I? Okay, I do. deliberately not bothering about the detail there. I can see it's not quite right, but I'm not going to worry. I'm going to put the colour on this roof down here. And the roof behind it. A line going across the top. Very tempted to move on to my mop now. Certain amount. We're getting around to a slightly warmer brown here. It's definitely like a sienna timber that they're using. Very typical Scandinavian colours, even though this is Austria. It's the Austrian colours, I should say. Colours here need to get more contrasty, and at the moment it's looking very untidy, but I will be coming back with a tighter detail brush in a short while. So at this stage the concept is that we're just putting in we're putting in the boxes, and I just noticed I've made a mistake on this box here. I really did want this building here in front, so I have to undo that. If I was left-handed, I would have worked in this job. I would have been happy to have gone from right to left, but I tend to be right-handed, so rather than smudge my work, I'd start this side and come back this way. That's my excuse for making a mistake like that, but anyway. It's actually quite brown under that either, or I was putting in a really dark contrasty colour. But I'll just try and get away with that. Now some details here. White building. I don't want to be too detailed. I want to leave that white as it is. Come down with a bit of a strong colour on that roof, and then I'll swap over to the blue side of things, the back of it. Once again, blue, brown, blue. Keep going till I'm happy. Just have to hang out there without knowing what to do yet. This one's, once again, I can start with a slightly purple edge on that. Goes right in. And I'll wet the brush, pull it back. Blue, brown. Shade under the awning. Use the same colour for that one. using the point of this brush. Now, I have to excuse that blowfly. Just can't get a painting done. Of course, I've got the puppy dog in the corner of the room. I won't say her name because it just stirs her up. She thinks I'm calling her. And she's asleep in her bed. But I leave the door open in case she wants to get up and go out, and I don't want to stop what I'm doing. Couple of just little warm pick-me-up colours. If I wipe out the blue, I don't want to make it bright, but I just want to vary the fact that I've done a painting in two shades, in two colours. So I'm just putting a tiny bit of orange on the brush, putting it into a couple of little places that I know happen to have orange on them. Tiny bit there. Sometimes I'll do this with red. I'll go over a big picture, and who's to know, I might do it with this one yet. Pick out tiny bit of colour here and there, as if they've done it on their windows when they haven't. Okay. More than enough. At the back here, I'll be lightening that with white. Mm-hmm. I'll be adding in detail here now. I have to decide how much detail to add in. You don't want to draw all over it really, really neatly, but on the other hand, you do want to define some areas so that people look at it and can see what's happening. You don't want it to be a total mystery. So that's very dry there now, so one of the first things I'll do is mix up a grey again, a bluey grey. I'll at least put in some of these into tiny little details where tops of the buildings are defined. Be careful, I'll keep putting my finger down that I don't totally stain the paper with the wrong colour. For example, that yellow now is very wet. I've got to be careful I don't pick it up. Move it around where I didn't need to. So there's another tree here. I'm doing trees at the moment. Always fun. One of the reasons I like trees, you can't go wrong. If they haven't got the right shape, that's just the way they are. I'm going to have to turn this page off. I'm going to have to get a bit closer to these details, just so that I can put in a few more pontoony type shapes. Use the sides, see this brush is beginning to lose its ability to hold still. imagine that that, I can't see the detail there, but I'll just imagine there's pontoons there. There's definitely one here where the main jetty is, and it's quite dark underneath that. So I'll just go around the top of the boat, make sure the boat's clear from the land. Back of the boat needs a little bit of detail. Obviously run it down the side. Windows at the side. Now, trees. I'll choose a very dull green. I don't want it to be bright at all for this tree. Same with the one beside it. Detail. It's there. Windows. Lovely roof on this. So I'll just go for it. It's not necessarily going to be very accurate. Kind of circular at the top. It's a mathematical challenge being those quarters coming down. I'll take it right up to as thin as I can get it. I'll put that little ball on the top. So I might make these windows longer. I'll extend them so that they're a little bit exaggerated. Some more detail at the back. Chimney, chimney, chimney on that building. This one here has some big spots on it. They're really windows, but I'll just call them spots. And then doors, doors, doors. Shadow under the awning. And shadow on this side. Oh, I call those awnings, but they're eaves. I think we've got a solar panel at the back. It's quite interesting. One more. Buildings there. So we'll keep going for blue and brown. Now the fun thing here is some very strong tree trunks. Side of this building. And they feather out to nothing. Very hard to do with this type of brush, but I will start that way and I might come back and do it another way. And up here. And oh, what I haven't done up the top there is that background. What I might do, just for the fun of it, I'll do the trees first up here. I'll just pretend that these trees are against the sky. Maybe blue and brown in. And then lots of branches going up. Work around that little turret. And then I'll wet the brush. Smudge the bottom half. Blend it down into there. Right, a little bit of green there. I'll bring that green back not really there, they're all brown, but pretend there's a touch of greenery happening. Okay. I'll come back to that in a minute when that area around there dries. In fact, that would be something I could probably do. Roughen that area up. Okay. Just checking the colours. Somewhere here I have a transparent red oxide, which I think might be that. And I've been calling it burnt sienna. I don't think I've got as burnt sienna, but I think you could substitute a burnt sienna. And I do think that's going to be the accurate colour for a lot of these buildings. Come over that way and start putting in a few details of these buildings that could benefit from that red colour. Walk through the fire, the sun. Make up a white edge on that window, and the red back into the brown there. Imagine the views they have up there. I do. I spend a lot of my time musing about what people must have. Sort of a life they have. Actually, in reality, they're probably all rented out. So this building here has got shadow coming down there. Definitely need to add more detail here now. And I shall do it with... That's interesting. I think there's a lovely shade going down like that. Across like that. Which is all very nice. And there's shades coming out here. Going right to the edge. I haven't noticed that, that's nice. And there's probably one underneath there too. Go down, make sure that doesn't run. tiny bit of greenery in the front here. And then some, these trees that are growing up inside. Lines. Believe it or not, they have a little walkway going up there. There's a shadow coming down. So trees here. Some of them are green and some of them are not. I won't ever do that. I have to define what's happening here. Now I think that's a blue building there coming down. It doesn't really matter what colour it is, it's just that if it's already got a colour, you may as well use what's there. Having to make a decision on will red work, will blue work. If it's already been done for you by using the photograph, you may as well just grab that. I'm just darkening out underneath these ears now to try and give them a bit of three-dimensional feel against that dark that's already there. Has a ridge on the top, so that's the sort of detail I'd like to put in at this stage. Continue with the detail over there, more windows. Sometimes I fiddle around with a window and can't get that cross, the white cross, and I sort of think, why do I bother? I know I'm going to come back later and just fudge it all in with gouache. More chimneys. This one here needs to be very dark. It's so close. Same in here. Holding my breath. I like to do these details. I love them, but I have to be very careful. Looks like some of that gold colour I put in before is run, but I don't mind. Yeah, some of those things I've put in there, I'm not real happy about. I'm just going to smooth them out a bit. Like that one there should come right down like that. Another shadow going across like that. Another shadow down there. This has to be red at the front here. But I'm going to try and orange it up a little bit, just for the sake of variety. I still want it to be true to the red, the redness of the local timber. I just want it to get that little bit of punch at the front. I'm going to run it down into the pick some of it out because it's not neat and tidy, it's all weather-worn. Same back here, that shadow has disappeared on me, I'll put that back in. And I'll also add the detail. And then get a slightly wet brush and smooth out the base part. Darken that. What I'm going to do is darken that there, and then I'll darken the reflection in the water. That area there has got that brown. I've got to put that down in the water too. Oh, red. Okay. Got red on my wall. That's tempting. Okay. I'll just smudge it out. A bit of water. It's there, but Every now and then you get a little bit of unusual colour coming back up here, and there's some unusual colour about there. Look at that across there, and that goes down into the water. Oh, just notice that big white thing there. Didn't see that before. Decide what to do with that. Do I make it into a pole? I might do that. In which case I have to think about how to do it so it doesn't look weird. There's a tree's growing there. Okay, I'm just going to give it some stripes. Give it a bit of activity around the base. And then using wet water, try and pick out white underneath, but I might be better off doing that with gouache. So I think what's happened at the back here, these little white pontoon type shapes, we're distracting. Okay, so back to the car park back here. Let's put in some structure. Maybe the odd little red car. Tap in here. Not too happy with this here. My eye's going, that's fine, but it's getting caught up there going, what the heck's going on? So I do need to come back in that area with some dark browns. And a controllable brush. So let's see if I can make this brush do what it's told. Let's run some vertical lines through that roof. Diagonal. Dark behind. Sometimes when things don't look right, it's something really simple like the shade, the light and dark is not right. Something hits your head, hits your eye and it goes, no, can't quite get that. So I'm just putting the shady areas underneath the eaves. Define the shapes better. Edge of the water better. Angles of roofs, that matters. I might darken that one off. Sometimes too much information. Take some out. You always come back later with the gouache and put it back in again. Yeah, I think that's helped that area a little bit. And I'll just add a bit more tiny little fiddly bits at the back here. Thank you.
I'm just putting a little bit more wash around here than I didn't, and that some little spots there that I just decided I'd add. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this painting. I hope you learned a little bit from it. I hope you can have a go, and I'll have the sketch will be up on my website pretty much soon at the same time as the photograph, so you can get the photograph and the sketch, and you can have a go at doing this beautiful little scene from Austria. So thanks very much for sticking with me. It's a long one, but I'll see you in about 5 days time when I upload the next one. Bye bye.